It's quite obvious that we at Evo India absolutely adore the Thar.
I would put down my money on the Thar.
Thar is to Mahindra what the 911 is to Porsche.
End of the day, isn't this why you buy a Thar? To be able to do all this?
Like a lot of you guys have correctly pointed out, we haven't lived with a Thar. So until we get a long-term test Thar, we cannot really comment on the long-term ownership experience. And that's where you guys, friends of Evo India, have handily come in. Welcome then to our new series, Early Adopters, where we are going to be speaking to enthusiasts who are living with the Thar. All your queries, including whether the new Thar can be your daily driver, we will get these Thar owners to answer those queries. Straight then from the horse's mouth. We start our series with Parag Rajda, who we first caught up with thanks to his passion for fast cars. A member of Speedfest, a club of India's finest sports and track day cars, Parag's garage has a Mercedes-AMG C63S parked front and centre. A proper petrol head, he also has a gorgeous W126 Mercedes 560 SEL, a Bonnie and the legendary RD350.
I'm actually surprised that of all my cars, the one that turns the most heads on the streets of Bombay is the Thar. Hi, I'm Parag Rajda and I own a Mahindra Thar. And over the past 6 months, I've used the Thar more than any of my other cars.
Parag is such a hardcore petrol head, he channeled his passion for cars into an entrepreneurial journey, setting up India's only carbon composite facility catering exclusively to motorsport and global manufacturers.
First and foremost, we're really missing a SUV in the garage, and we wanted an SUV that was practical, that was cost effective, good value for money, and the Thar ticked all those boxes. In the city is the first time that I am out on the streets fearless. With my other cars, I'm always worried about somebody coming into me, scratching me, he's too close, he's touching. And with this car, everybody else is worried about he's too close, he's touching. I've actually seen rickshaws move out of the way. I've never had that experience before, so I'm totally enjoying it. We've been to Chikmagalur, we've been to Belgaum, we've been to friend's farm at least 3 or 4 times because he has a huge property and we go there off-roading. And it's just so much fun and everybody is fighting for the keys of the Thar because everybody wants to be the one driving the Thar at the farm. So both my wife and I were avid road trippers at one point of time, and then kids came along and work came along and we just got busy and we forgot the joy of road tripping. And the Thar is sort of rekindled that passion where every weekend we want to get into the Thar and drive off to some location, even if it's something around Bombay. So we are totally enjoying that side of owning a Thar.
The Thar though, it is also a hardcore machine. And I'm not sure that Parag has really dug deep into the off-road capabilities of this new Thar. And that's why we are taking him on a road trip from Mumbai to Igatpuri to Mahindra Adventures Off-Road Academy to really put the Thar through its paces in the place where it was tested on a proper off-roading track. So Parag, before you came to the academy, what did you expect that the Thar could do?
You know, quite frankly, I was expecting quite a bit, and I'm happy to say that it's delivering on all fronts. The things that we saw it do today is just spectacular. Unlike a lot of the SUVs you get in the market today, which are soft off-roaders, for want of a better word. This is a proper off-roader. I mean, just look at the kind of roads we've been through today. the angles it has taken and how easily it has gone through all of it is just amazing.
So now, after having lived with the Thar, now doing a bit of off-roading with the Thar, to sum up, your opinion on the Thar?
So like I was telling a friend of mine, the more you drive it, the more you like it. Mm-hmm. And I think that sums up the Thar. I was skeptical, my family was skeptical, why are we getting a Thar? And now it has become the default vehicle that we use.
Parag, we get tons of questions on the Thar, but the one that we get the most often is, can the Thar be a daily driver? Can it be an option to a compact SUV, a mid-size SUV, even a premium hatchback? And can it be the one car in your garage?
I don't see any reason why it can't be. It's got everything that you'd want from a car that you drive every day in the city. It's comfortable. It's got great air conditioning. It's easy to drive. And with the way the Bombay streets are, you need a car like this because you literally need to go almost anywhere on those streets.
So there you have it from the horse's mouth. The Thar can be your daily driver. If you have any more interesting, pertinent, relevant questions on the Thar, drop it in the comments below and we will take it up on our next episode of Early Adopters. We were going to meet Thar owners, guys who've got enthusiast cars, and ask them why they're using the Thars on a regular daily basis.
Subscribe to the Evo India channel and hit the bell icon to keep pace with the thrill of driving.